determine the domain and range of the given functions from the graphs. Recall the domain is the set of all inputs or x values, and the range is a set of all outputs or y values. First, we have the graph of y equals log x. The graph appears to touch the y-axis, but recall log functions have vertical asymptotes. In this case, the vertical asymptote is the line x equals 0, this line here, or the y-axis. The graph approaches this vertical line, but never touches it. This is important because it will affect the domain. And now to determine the domain, we analyze the behavior of the graph from left to right because the x values, or the x-axis, runs from left to right. Notice on the left, the x values approach x equals 0, but never reach x equals 0, and the graph goes to the right indefinitely, and therefore the domain, or set of all possible inputs, would be x greater than 0, which would be this graph here along the x-axis. To express the domain using interval notation, we would express a domain as the open interval from 0 to infinity. Or again, using inequalities, we could say x greater than 0. We would do one or the other, not both. To determine the range, we want to analyze the graph vertically. Notice how the graph goes down indefinitely, which indicates the outputs or y values approach negative infinity. The graph appears like it may have a horizontal asymptote, but that's actually not true. The graph does go up indefinitely, just very slowly. And therefore, the range, or set of all possible y values, would be all real numbers along the y-axis. To express the range using interval notation, we would have the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. Using inequalities, we would say y greater than negative infinity and less than positive infinity. And looking at the graph on the right, notice now the vertical asymptote is at x equals 3, this vertical line here. So again, the graph approaches this vertical line, but never actually touches it. Again, to determine the domain, we analyze the graph from left to right. Notice the graph goes left indefinitely, and the x values approach negative infinity. And then to the right, the x values approach the vertical asymptote of x equals 3, which indicates the domain would be x less than positive 3, which would look like this. Using interval notation, we have the open interval from negative infinity to positive 3. Using inequalities, we have x less than 3. And then again, to determine the range, we analyze the graph vertically. The graph goes down indefinitely, and therefore the y values approach at negative infinity. And once again, it does appear as if we may have a horizontal asymptote, but that's not true. The graph also continues to go up indefinitely, even though it goes up very slowly. So the range of this function is the same as the range of the first log function, where the outputs or y values are in the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity, or the y values are all real numbers. Which is true for any log function. Using inequalities, we have y greater than negative infinity and less than positive infinity. I hope you found this helpful.